Happy Pollinator Week! Hi everyone, I'm Rachel, and I'm a biologist at Tufts University and Washington State University. You may have seen me around the Discovery Museum at my All About Bees program. Every year, the third week in June is dedicated to celebrating pollinators. There are many different types of pollinators, but I study bees and butterflies for my research, so I know a lot about those. And today, in honor of Pollinator Week, I'm going to be showing you how to make a bee hotel. When most people think of bees, they think of honeybees or bumblebees. But did you know there are actually 4,000 species of bees in North America, and over 350 species live right here in New England? And most of those bees are solitary bees, which means they don't live in colonies like honeybees and bumblebees do. Instead, there's one mother bee that makes her nest, lays eggs, and makes sure that her young has enough food. Many of these bees need holes to nest in the side of wood or trees or even in the ground. And today we're going to make a bee hotel, which provides these solitary bees with possible nesting sites. For the bee hotels we're going to make today, you need scissors, string or twine, a soup can that's been emptied and cleaned, and paper straws. The first thing you're going to want to do is take one of your paper straws and figure out how long you want to cut it for your soup can. So you want the straw to be almost as long as the soup can, but a little bit shorter. This will allow a little bit of overhang, see, and some protection for these bee nesting sites. With a grown-up's help, cut enough straws so that you can fill up your whole soup can. Something you can use instead of paper straws are hollowed out stems or reeds that you can find in your backyard. Once your can is nice and full of straws or nesting sites, take a piece of twine or string and tie it around the middle of your can. And now you have a bee hotel that you can hang up somewhere in your yard or near a community garden. When you hang up your bee hotel, you want to make sure it's in a safe spot for the bees, so off the ground, and somewhere where bees can find food. So bees visit flowers in order to find their own food. Pollen provides protein, and nectar provides carbohydrates and fats. And as you can see here, we have a nice pollinator garden behind us, which will provide the bees with all of the food they need. If you want to watch your bee hotel and identify which types of bees actually use it, you can download a Common Bees of New England identification guide in the link below or online from the Tufts Pollinator Initiative. We have mason bees and leafcutter bees, both of which are identified as bees that use these types of bee hotels.